large portions of this conversation have been deeply disturbing, frankly, because so much of it has felt like a pile-on against and attacks on workers. And I have a question, but I want to respond to what Mr. Moreland said, that people don't value a paycheck anymore, that people don't value hard work, that I guess he's suggesting that people are just lazy and don't want to come out and work. And I don't think the data bears that out. And I think this is the problem with having a hearing today about a worker shortage and not including one worker, not including one person from organized labor, and having a conversation that is completely from the perspective of the employer without talking to in any detail workers. And so I would hope that we would have a follow-up conversation that really looks at what workers are experiencing and while workers are staying out of the workforce. Mr. Moreland, one of the things you highlighted was that there's a 39% increase in salaries, that this represents a 48-year high in terms of employers raising their salaries. I know that you've talked about that number, I guess celebrating that as a good thing that employers are doing, and I would say that it's a good thing, but it's actually something that's pretty tragic, that this is what it has taken for there to be an increase. The other thing I would love for you to respond to is what's happening in Texas, where they have cut the expanded unemployment benefits and are seeing similar issues with a full workforce complement coming back. So we're seeing places like Texas where we've seen those benefits cut, and yet we're not seeing a full workforce back in all of our small businesses and larger employers as well.